Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the first quarter 2024 CFAY Town Hall. My name is Justin Keller. I'm the CFAY Public Affairs Officer. I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. Tonight, we're going to first hear about some of our current initiatives and upcoming events. Here tonight, we have representatives from Public Works, N9, FFSC, MWR, Housing Security, Emergency Management, Religious Ministries, and Ikego Detachment. Before that, Captain Silva is going to kick it off with some opening remarks.
Hey, everybody. Hey, thanks for coming here. First of all, the other thing is apostles here, right? So if you guys have questions for my esteemed colleague, Captain Hines, he's ready to answer anything you got. But the first thing I really want to talk about is Fleet Rec Gym. I'm getting a lot of questions about Fleet Rec Gym. Hey, Captain Silva, thanks for bringing Fleet Rec Gym online 24 hours, 7 days a week. We think it's awesome. Okay, cool. But some of the questions are, hey, can my children go and just unsupervised go to Fleet Rec Gym? The answer is no. And there's a lot of really good reasons for that. And one of them is, well, we don't think it's a really good idea for fleet sailors to be like, you know, pseudo childcare. So if you're going to have some of our areas there where it requires, you know, people to be 18 years old and older, like around basketball courts, your children can still go there, but the parent has to be with the child actively supervising it. And we think that's just sound judgment. Now, if Mass Chief Hunt tells me otherwise, I reserve the right to change my mind. But at this point, that's where we're at with that. Another thing that came up was folks like, hey, Capsule, can you do anything about transit time to get people on base? And I was like, well, absolutely. So, you know, we noticed that there were some backups, and we contacted the city, and they altered the traffic lights a little bit. So there's like a different timing between 3 seconds and 5 seconds. We were on the wrong side of that. And it kind of impacted the traffic flow. So, you know, I got with my security officer, and he went there and he posted extra guys to kind of figure out what was going on. And really kind of what he saw was, besides the traffic lights, he saw a lot of people on their phones in their cars. And that's also contributing to the backups. So, you know, the city's gonna do their part to help us out, but I got to ask the community to kind of do your part too and kind of put the phone down and let's get through this smoothly together. Sound about good? Okay, that's really all I got for now. We'll take any questions anybody got at the end, and we're going to turn it over to the Public Works Officer, Mr. Tyler Sherrod. Thanks,
Tyler. All right, good evening. I'm Commander Tyler Sherrod, the Public Works Officer. I'll talk to you tonight about several ways that we can recycle and get rid of different types of solid waste material products. So in Public Works, recently noticed a gap and created a new program called the Household Hazardous Waste Reuse Program. Located back by the auto fort. So U.S. goods that are at least half full, clean and usable, can be delivered there. You have some examples like household cleaners, kitchen cleaners, bleach, alcohols, non-drinking, isopropyl alcohols. We're open 2 hours a day. During the Monday through Friday, we're going to stagger morning, afternoon. If you know people coming to Yokosuka, maybe they need to fill their shelf, please have them stop by. People leaving Yokosuka, we especially need your help filling the shelf, so please consider, don't put this in the waste stream, don't put this in the trash, drop it off for someone else to use. We greatly appreciate it. Next, there's a few other programs on base that help you get rid of things that maybe shouldn't go in the trash or even in the recycling container in front of your house or tower. So the qualified recycling program is located, they're all located back by the auto port. It's run by Public Works. They'll take various types of scrap metals, textiles, cooking oil. So please use them. We actually sell those products to recycling companies, and then we use the proceeds to build projects on the base. The MWR Auto Skills Center, it's located behind the next auto port. They'll take various car-related products like batteries and engine oils. And then finally, the next car care center, they'll also take car-related items, such as the flares that come out of your car when they expire, or batteries, or gasoline, diesel. So please use those, help divert the right stuff out of our waste stream and get it to the right recycling or disposal process. Thank you. I'll now turn it over to N9. Thank you,
Brian. I'm Mike Cronin, Captain Bob. What's going on with N9? N9-1, Fleet and Family Veterans. Okay, Fleet and Family Support Center. Lots of stuff going on. This whole building is filled up with people that want to help you. Classes, programs, counseling, everything that you need to become the person that you want to be. This month, we've got Career Fair, the Debt Disorder Workshop, Tax Prep 101. We're celebrating social workers. This only scratches the surface of everything that we're providing. Please come out, talk to the people. They'll be glad to tell you what's going on. And Ikego, ESL, where people are learning the English language through watching old films. Extremely popular, people are having a good time with it, and our regularly scheduled Zushi Hayama tour, where you can go out and learn more about the local area. MWR in Mactu. Captain talked about the fleet gym going to 24 hours. It was a demand for it. We heard it. We made it happen. And it's going to swing right in and help us out with the Purdy Fitness Center closure. This is having to happen because they're getting a new air conditioner installed. It's going to be shut down for 15 months, and that's a long time. But we have set up alternate locations. We're providing everything we can to make that hurt just a little bit less. Please go out and see the video that we created. Help to ease the pain and approach it from our new part. Spring Fest coming up. It's going to be everything you expect it to be. There's going to be food. There's shows. There is carnival games, live music, beverages, ship visits, and 30,000 of our favorite people coming through the gate to share it with us. Flea market right outside coming up on Saturday. The Oscars. This is a free event where they play three movies nominated for Oscars, and you get to choose which one you think should be the winner. Salsa night. If you haven't been to Salsa night, if you haven't been to Latin night at the Alliance Club, you're missing out. I'm there all the time, can't dance a bit, and I have a blast. Taylor Swift, look-alike, lip sync. Tell me you don't want to go to this and see something. Ikego Movie Night. Drive-in Movie Night, that's coming up this Friday. Hidden Figures, St. Patrick's Day celebration at most of our clubs. Club 8 is the only one not celebrating this year. Is that going to be driving movie? What's that, Secretary? Is that going to be driving movie? We're planning on being a driving movie, but weather permitting. We may have to move it to the elementary school there in the cafeteria. We hear they're actually calling for snow. So be aware. And the housing department. Preventive medicine inspections are going to resume this month. I'd like to talk just a little bit about the temporary access to military housing. If you're going on leave, please contact the Housing Service Center 7 days prior. You can have house sitters, but remember, you're still responsible. Ikego Townhouse Renovation, 56 townhouses, newly renovated by May 2024. How cool is that? And now we pass over to security.
Good evening, folks. Ensign Hunt, CFAY Security Officer. We'll talk to you about our ongoing areas of focus.
Abandoned vehicles. Got a lot of comments regarding abandoned vehicles, abandoned bicycles, so we're doing our part. We appreciate your guys' reports. That always helps us out, so please continue to do so. If you have any suspected abandoned vehicles, abandoned bicycles, you would see that over the weekend we collect about 30 or so plus bicycles, make Facebook news. So again, we appreciate the community's comments on that. We're also evaluating our high traffic procedures and manning, just to see if there's ways we can be more efficient while also retaining our security measures, because we are not going to sacrifice the safety and security of our community members.
Our future areas of focus, we have road tax event at Fleet Theater, 18 to 19 March and 11 to 12 April. Do not worry if you cannot make those event dates. You can pay outside of those dates and at Yokosuka City Hall. Our 2024 DK display deadline is 01 June 2024, so please get that registration done prior to that deadline, or else you will be riding dirty, and we do not endorse that. PAO is required if you or your spouse cannot register your vehicles, so please make sure you have that in order.
If you have two or more vehicles, please ensure that you fully complete the registration process for both vehicles in order to obtain the decals. You cannot do one and then the other, so please ensure both are completed prior to your decal issue.
As you can see, we have up here the respective prices for the respective plate numbers. And if you'll see below, we have motorcycles and mini cars, which are not payable at this road tax event, so you have to go to City Hall. And if you have any questions, please call VRO at 243-5011.
Hey everyone, Mike May, Emergency Management. In light of the January 1 Noto earthquake, I just want to talk a little bit about earthquake preparedness. It was on everyone's mind at that point. So, back on January 1st, the 7.6 magnitude, really large earthquake over on the western coast of Japan, on kind of the opposite side of where we are. So we got a little bit of the feeling here. It was kind of a 3-4 magnitude here, so we felt it a little bit, but definitely much larger on the other side. You can see in that top right corner, the lighter colors, the heavier magnitude, that getting up to the darker colors where it was a little bit lighter. What I really want to talk about for that was the aftershock. So if you look at that, I know it's hard to read from the back there, but just look at the highlighted section here. This is about a month's worth of earthquake report. This is in February, so that was January 1st. This is February. And all those highlighted sections are aftershocks from that Noto earthquake. So they're all in Ishikawa, they're all Noto earthquakes. Smaller earthquakes, so much smaller aftershocks. But just be aware that if we do have earthquakes of that size or even smaller, sometimes you will get some aftershocks that can happen, you know, months after. So we do feel some of those sometimes. We also just had over on the Chiba side just recently, last week, was somewhere around a 5. So we felt that. I thought that some people didn't. But so just keep that in mind. But on the earthquake preparedness side, so what do we do? Kind of like stop, drop, and roll, right? So for earthquakes, it's drop, cover, and hold on. So drop, cover, hold on, cover your head. Whether you're in bed, you have a table, something you can get under. If you're in bed, just cover your head. Outside, you know, get away from buildings, get away from things that would fall. And just things to prepare for. So as we always talk about, is make sure you're preparing a kit. So get a kit ready to go, an emergency kit that's got all the stuff you need. For earthquakes, is try to strap stuff down. So if you have heavy furniture in your house, things like china cabinets, big mirrors, heavy dressers, things like that. If you want to, you can strap them down, tie them to the walls. Put something on there, right, to help stop those things from falling over. And then if you do have to leave the house, just make sure you plan with your family to make sure where you guys are going to meet up afterwards. So along with that earthquake, there was also a tsunami warning that came afterwards. It got canceled, so the tsunami didn't end up happening. But just a question that came up earlier at one of our ombudsman's meetings. We're talking about evacuation routes on base here. That was an important question to answer here too. So the question was, you know, is there a singular evacuation route on base for tsunamis? The answer is no. And the reason for that is, you'll see all these signs posted around base. Hopefully as you drive around base, you've seen these posted up all over base. The evacuation route signs are directing you to evacuation sites. So all over base, there are plenty of evacuation sites. You'll see these blue signs on the far right here. Posted up on buildings, so pretty much all of your towers, gyms, anything that's usually over two stories, some of the parking towers, all have these signs posted on them. And these evacuation route signs are directing you to the closest evacuation site. Right? So we're not telling you to go to one particular location. It's going to direct you to the closest site to where you're at, to get you up above the second floor, and then have you tune in to listen for additional emergency information. So coming from our CDMS system, coming from Commander's channel, or coming from our social media sites. So again, to the evacuation site, high floors, and then wait for additional information. With that, I will turn to you, Jess.
Thanks, Mike. Good afternoon, Chaplain Dave Kim, your friend, the neighborhood chaplain. It's a busy time with the chaplain. Just wanted to highlight a few events. At the end of this month is Holy Week for our Christian traditions, so it's Good Friday and Easter. There's a bunch of different events, but leading up to Holy Week, for our Catholic community, every Friday there'll be having Stations of the Cross, and that's followed by a meatless potluck dinner. So if you would like to join them, if you observe Lent in that way, please do so. On Easter Sunday itself, all of our Protestant services are actually going to be worshiping together, not at the chapel because that would be too small. We're actually going to be in Benedict Theater at 1000 on Easter Sunday morning. So please join us there. And then following that, we actually have a combined Easter picnic with our Catholic community after their 1100 Mass. We're all going to be celebrating Easter together behind the chapel in the area between the chapel and the ZRC here. So please come out. I'm not taking attendance. If you didn't attend church that morning, you can still come out. We'll still feed you. But please feel free to celebrate with us. Our Jewish community has a few other few holidays as well. Later in March, they will be celebrating Purim, not at the chapel, but at the Sakura community room. And in April, they'll be celebrating Passover. So if you'd like to be involved in those commemorations, please contact Rabbi Hamilton over at the chapel. One last thing we want to highlight as well, in late April, April 22nd through May 20th, the main sanctuary of our chapel will be getting new overhead lighting. And so we'll be in scaffolding, and it will not be safe for us to be in that space. So all the worship services you may be used to going to on Saturday and Sunday during that time will be either moved to Benny Decker Theater or to the Kodo Auditorium on the second floor here. So those times and days are listed here, but please check our Facebook site for any changes that might occur last minute. Well, finally, one thing that's not up here is Ramadan services. That starts next week, but our Muslim lay leader has PCS, and so we are looking for a volunteer. If you know of any volunteers that would be able to lead our Muslim community, not just for Ramadan, but for the monthly year following, please contact me, or for any other faith group that's not represented. We are always looking for volunteers to help represent the faith groups that are here on this base, so please come talk to us. But also a reminder that the majority of people that we talk to don't have a faith background at all. You don't need to have a faith background to talk to the chaplain. We are here to talk to you and your family and offer 100% confidentiality and pastoral counseling. So please come visit us. We are here to take care of you and our community. Thanks.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Lieutenant Taylor of OIC for Ikego Detachment, and here are our updates for the community. So the first thing, to make sure you stay in the loop of everything going on at Ikego, we have a newsletter, and the easiest way to do that is to sign up for it by emailing ikegodetachment@gmail.com. That's also another means to talk with the liaison office. If you aren't able to call or come into the office physically, you can email us, and we monitor that regularly so that we can address whatever concerns or questions you may have. Additionally, this QR code, as well as the website link below it, this gives the overview of all the construction projects that are going on at Ikego. As we know, we've started a lot of things are planned in the coming years as well, so it gives an overview of all those project sites. It gives notional dates, time windows of when those are expected, but we all know times are notional, so don't hold those to us, but we will be sure to communicate any type of closures, sidewalk closures, parking lot closures, things like that to the community through our newsletter. So another way to plug you to sign up. For our train riders out of Ikego, just for your awareness, starting 31 March, the Keikijimuji station, they will be downsizing their manning, so they won't have a gate attendant there between the hours of 0500 and 0700. So for our morning commuters, what that means for you is that if you need any assistance from the KQ line, there will be a video intercom installed at the card recharge station. So all you have to do is push the button. They'll connect you with an attendant at Kanagawa Bunko station to assist you. Another reminder for the community is to make sure that we are all good community neighbors and adhere to the posted signs for parking in the Club T next to CDC parking lot specifically. There are the designated 15-minute pickup and drop-off parking spots, as well as the 4-hour parking. So make sure that we are being good neighbors and allowing those that need to utilize those services the opportunity to do so, and then park your vehicle either in the long-term parking, along parallel parking down the street, or to go for a walk and enjoy the beautiful sun to utilize those services. Additionally, same reminder goes for the Ikego Elementary School. Please adhere to the no drop-off times throughout the week, in the morning and the afternoon. We want to make sure that the children can get to and from school safely without any vehicles obstructing those crosswalks and sidewalks near the school. For the far right here, just a reminder as well, there's 3 orange cones outside of Ikego's gate along the side once you come off the railroad tracks. We ask that you please don't park your vehicles there as you either wait to pick up your children, pick up packages, or pick up anything else that might be coming to the gate. We ask that you come through the gate, park in the parallel parking there so that we don't obstruct traffic coming from the railroad. Additionally, a reminder for the kids, we want to keep all the children safe through the community as well as the adults too, if you care about everybody. But please remind yourselves and your children to wear your helmets, walk across the crosswalks properly with those bicycles, and for the drivers, please make sure you're adhering to stop signs, speed signs as well, so that everybody stays safe. And lastly, thank you to those who supported our outreach event this past weekend. It was a great turnout. We got something coming for you guys in the month of April. We're still finalizing some of the vendors for our farmers market, but please be on the lookout for signs and postings and all the things for the farmers market to come out and have a good time with your liaison office. So, Penny, any questions? That's all I have. And now we'll transition to the Q&A.
Here's into the Q&A session. We're going to start with some of the questions we received from the community over the last week via social media and email. So the first one was for MWR.
Oh, I got this.
Question is, how long does it take to buy a vending machine? Last year, MWR shared that they were in the process of procuring the equipment and targeted January and February for the return fees.
Yeah, I'm good. When we went in and pulled the bingo machine out to fire it up to be sure that everything was right, guess what? It wasn't right. And the OS on it was so old we couldn't get security updates for it. So at first we tried to fix it, we tried to repair it, we tried to find some sort of workaround, and there was just no way to do it. So we went out, found a new machine, put in a purchase request for it, and the reality is it's going to take about 3 or 4 months to get here. But we're going to go with the manual system because there is a demand for bingo here. We're going to go with the manual system, and that will be at the Chiefs Club on April the 20th. So look for the advertisement on the MWR Facebook page.
Okay. And the next question is actually for FFSC. I'm completing my master's degree in a few weeks and obviously can't attend stateside graduation ceremony. I know in the past CFAY has had college graduation for online students. I have reached out to FFSC about the possible graduation, but they do not have any information. Will there be a graduation ceremony this year similar to last year?
There will be. You have a great achievement in your life. You want to walk. You want to share this event with your family and friends. We want you to be able to do that. So, yes, the answer is yes. So, you get to walk, throw that tassel around, you'll be in there.
Anything else?
I think that's it.
Okay. Next question is actually for Public Works. And it's, can you please explain who picks up pets at the airport?
So, I presume this is for official travel. So, obviously, leave travel. It's self-funded, although you are allowed to ride space available on the shuttle. For official travel, we actually revised the CFAY instruction this year to make it even clearer. So you're on funded orders, and you should procure commercial transportation. The best way to do that on base is the next taxi service. That's a contractor the next has that provides transportation to Narita and Haneda airports. They also have special vans that can fit pets, so please call next taxi and reserve that early. Other ways we offer for transportation that's allowed by joint travel regulations is consider public trains and buses. A lot of people, maybe without kids or pets or large pets, do ride the train and find it very simple to get here from Narita, about an hour on the train. You can procure a taxi. You can order your sponsor for the command to use a duty vehicle to drive and pick you up, as many sponsors do. And you can consider a rental car, although I understand there may be some complications driving in a foreign country. There is a known gap related to Yokosuka, so the next taxis do not currently service Yokosuka. We have asked the next to revise their contract, and they're in progress of doing that. So in the near future, a new next taxi contract will service Yokosuka. It'll also expand some of the services for pets, more clearly identifying what size kennels they can fit, what size cages they can fit, and to buy more vehicles that fit pets for that service.
The time would be clear. Pets don't go in government vehicles.
Not in government vehicles, yes, sir. You're welcome to also go through friend networks and social media networks, and people on base have often offered rides, possibly for gas money or otherwise. But please do use those networks, especially your sponsor as you arrive in the country. That's your question. First of all, you want me to answer my other questions?
Yes, yeah, so I think the next one is, will CFAY ever bring back the Ikego Family Shutter Show? It was a great service that helped Ikego residents feel less isolated.
So during COVID, CFAY used the Navy policy that allows emergent circumstances to have some increased offerings. So because we were direct assigning people to housing and people were arriving in Ikego, you know, without any stops, without any housing briefs, et cetera, under emergent conditions, the Navy allowed us to operate an appropriated fund shuttle to Ikego for those official duty purposes. Since COVID, we are not allowed to continue shuttle to for the purposes of non-official business. So we do have services to Ikego Home to Work, which is approved by the CNO and specifically outlined for the service it provides people going to and from work. But unfortunately, there's no enduring policy to fund a appropriate fund to shuttle for non-official duty.
Thank you. And then our next question is for security. And it is, can there be an abandoned bicycle sweep base-wide? There are at least 5 bikes at Purim. They're taking spaces and have not been moved in weeks.
Yes, so again, as I brought up earlier, we picked up about 30 bicycles this weekend. In the last month, we junked about 4 or 5 abandoned vehicles. So again, please, as a community, report it. We'll take care of it. We do ask, you know, in favor with our balance of operational requirements, calls to service, inspection. So there is a lot going on within security, but again, we will take care of those issues for the community.
And then our next question is, what is the update on the security outside of Ikego Elementary School during pickup and drop-off?
From the last time, all of you remember, we had, that was one of our initiatives to provide more security to the school. We have done that, maybe not as much as the community sees, but again, it is a balance between our operational requirements, calls of service, and our inspections. So again, I have personally directed my patrol units to go there and show presence and again, ensure the safety and security of our community members and our youth. So that is again, a priority of security. And we continue to ensure that our folks are supported.
Thank you. And then our next question is for Ikego housing area. Question is, can we have 2 additional crosswalks near the intersection in front of Ikego school gate repainted? One is about 50% faded and the other is nearly invisible.
So there was already a project in process for the entire Ikego Elementary School area to be repainted on the drive, the roadways. That does include the 2 intersections mentioned at the entrance to the Ikego Elementary School. We're trying to schedule that for the spring break week, so you should see it pretty soon. Thanks.
And then the next and final question is, can the current and future Ikego construction projects be shared with the public? What buildings are being erected, renovated, and permanently demolished? Will we be getting a permanent skate park and basketball hoops again?
So, good question. So, 6 to 9 months ago, we created that website. So, if you Google, probably the most used website, I think, is the airport shuttle, and maybe the fast office. But after that, we did add about a year ago the projects. You'll see a map up there. Because we're building about 12 new projects roughly around the base, we wanted to tell you where those are. They'll be built over the next 8 to 10 years. But that'll show you what's under construction, rough year, and you saw the QR code during this brief. And then the last question was impacts to Ikego with the skate park. I know the Ikego debt has been actively looking for a location. They believe they've found one, and we're in the final steps of approving that parking lot for that use, and MWR will help the skate park and probably works to put up a fence, and we're moving quickly at that. Thanks.
All right, thank you. And so now we're gonna open up the floor to questions. So this is your time, so feel free to ask anything or share anything that you have. So if anybody has any questions, please raise your hand. No questions.
Hey everybody, thanks for coming out. We really appreciate you being here. You have a question?
I do.
Okay, what's your question?
I do.
Please.
My friend and I here are part of the Yokosuka Sushi Bowlers.
We're big supporters.
I know, and we appreciate that very much. We have a few members of our team who are Japanese citizens, and they love to come and join us for breakfast when they can. And so we have members of the team who will sponsor them and help them to get on base for practices when they can make it. But a couple of months ago, how long ago was it?
I believe it started in end of December, beginning of January, maybe. Holidays kind of messed everything up a little bit for a lot of people. The process got a lot more complicated. It used to be that they could get a pass for a certain amount of time, and so all we had to do was somebody would go pick them up, and it was a lot easier to get them on base for a practice. But now they have to go to the pass and ID office to get a brand new pass every single time they come on base, and so it's got a lot more complicated.
It got a little more complicated, and I can kind of help with this, right?
Yeah, please.
There were some sailors on the base that were skirting some rules, and they made an adjustment to the process, very necessary. And they were abusing it. They were bringing people into unauthorized areas on the base, and we had to really do what was right for the best of the community. And I know that impacted some people, but you know, at the end of the day, I was assured by my security officer, Mr. Hunt, that if people just put a very good reason, like a rational reason as to why they needed the additional pass, that we would work with them. Is that still true?
Yes, sir. Okay.
So we heard you. We're just trying to balance it. So yeah. I appreciate the feedback.
Got it. Thank you.
Hey, no problem. Any other questions? All right, listen, thanks everybody for being here. We really appreciate you being here. Thank you so much. Have a great evening.